Hello, everybody, and welcome back after the break. Hope you had a nice break, everybody. But we are back for round eight. It's still six rounds ahead of us. People are still trying to get that day two invite. And I'm joined here today. I'm Marcus Pilar, by the way, and I'm joined here today by Martin Wagner. How you doing, Martin?
I'm doing great. Just had a little bit of a short break, go outside, get some fresh air, and go back with some fresh energy. And we bring back some a player that we had. We'll bring back a player that we had earlier, Yoshiyuki. But first, we want to talk about the overall meta, right? We want to talk a little bit how the meta has developed with the new set, what we see, and what we will expect going forward.
Exactly. So the meta, as we can just say, it's been very diverse. That's something I don't think anybody can deny. New cards means always there will be new decks, but we saw especially that older decks have just become stronger. How do you note? How did you note that throughout the day?
Yeah, I think for this tournament especially, just older decks that have existed already and are just being upgraded with new cards will perform way better than decks that are completely like newly invented. So that's at least my expectation, because the builds for those decks are usually refined already, and you just swap around a few cards and your deck is working, right? You don't have to come up with a completely new engine or like with a completely new design for the deck. Like, for example, I expect like just my prediction or opinion is that like Pika or ADP Zacian will perform a little bit better than Dragapult, especially for this tournament, because
Oh
Dragapult is
yeah,
like super new and
definitely, definitely. Obviously, as soon as the deck comes out, it always needs some time to fine tune. Sometimes it wins the first tournament because people don't really expect it. But Dragapult has been the hyped up deck. We saw many people play ADP Tom. We saw people playing attacks against all these new against Dragapult especially. Overall, I think Dragapult needs to find its way. It's always like this. There are many versions, Malamar, non-Malamar. But I think it definitely has potential.
Yeah, for sure. It like the playstyle reminds me a little bit of back in the day when we had like Decidueye decks with Forest of Giant Plants, where you are able to snipe your damage and you don't really have a huge amount of damage output, but the damage counter placement is like so important. And yeah, you have to really get used to that and don't waste any damage counter. And I think if players adapt to it and yeah, just refine the game plan and strategies and builds a little bit, we will see Dragapult be successful in the later format.
Well said. It is a kind of deck that does not have much output damage, and in a meta in which control decks, I mean, more like lock possibilities are reduced to specific kind of decks, it's sometimes hard. As you mentioned, the Forest of Giant Plants had the opportunity to play Valtum, for example, and that's really slowed down your opponent. I think if Dragapult got something new in the new sets that, I don't know, locks the opponent out of trainers or maybe hand locks them, then it's possible that it would be a very hard deck to beat thanks to its HP and its attacks.
Yeah, 320 HP is like super hard to overcome, and I think we will see the meta shift a little bit more towards other VMAX Pokemon. I think there are a lot of VMAXes out there that have a lot of potential and that are not like as explored as even Dragapult. Like people haven't even tried to test them out, and I believe like stuff like Toxtricity would have a lot of potential. With the speed lightning and all the electro support that we have right now. But we will see how the meta will develop and how it will go forward. But I like the I always like cards that can be included in a variety of decks. I love Ditto Prism Star being added in Lost Thunder, and we kind of see a similar thing here with the Scoop Up Net, because it
Yeah, four
shifts,
off.
yeah, it shifts the way the game is played a little bit, right? Like
It's
not only the
basically,
meta, but also the gameplay, right?
it doesn't like it. We expect scoop up cards to be like big swing bags type of cards that you just take all the Pokemon, like the Pokemon with a lot of damage, and you negate your opponent's some prizes. Actually, the way we saw it right now, it's more like setup. It's a lot based on setup, do cute combos. We saw Stefan bringing forward that Jirachi Mr. Mime combo.
Yeah.
But overall, yeah, it's a very, it's like a consistency card. I think it will be staple for off in every deck, because honestly,
I agree. It gives you a lot of mobility on your early board, which can sometimes be a little bit clunky. If you, for example, start a tech Pokemon that you don't like, the Zigzagoons or the Mr. Mimes or the Baby Blacephalons, all that stuff that you can just scoop up and maybe go into a Jirachi and continue from there. So the added mobility given to all decks is really, really important, and it opens up the world of just come into play abilities as well, which is really interesting. We saw Mind Report Mewtwo had a huge influx of play, and also the Giratina, which can deny special energies, has also seen a lot of play. So I expect those cards only to go up and play as we move forward in this meta.
Absolutely, Martin. In other card games there are a lot of these ETB effect, enter the battlefield effects. I think Pokemon, there are some, but it's very hard to repeat them. It's very hard. They're not very impactful, but there are some specific cards, as you mentioned, for example, the Mewtwo or the Giratina. They can help you out in doing, helping you out, for example, to set up or to slow down your opponent. So it would be very interesting, I think, with the scoop up net in the game, to now have more entered battlefield, so entered bench Pokemon cards. It would be very interesting.
Overall, I think it's really important right now to remain like that. Your game plan is flexible and can adapt there to whatever your opponent does. Right, I think it's right now it's pretty hard to just go for one game plan every game and execute it all the time. I think it's the game has become a little bit more flexible and adaptive. Like you need to react to what your opponent does, or else you will just lose immediately.
Exactly. Especially since you don't know the meta, it's always good to keep yourself flexible. But obviously, we've seen today there are many decks that have used, for example, the Dark Box. Another, I think, a great application of the Scoop Up Net has been with the Darkrai Prism, boosting the energies.
That was super nice.
Yeah. We're just waiting for the players right now to set up. We're almost there. They've all checked in. We're just waiting for people to go down into their games, and we'll probably have two rounds since this is pool two, and pool two is starting quite early. Throughout the day has been probably the fastest pool of them all.
Yeah, they have been not taking any breaks, literally, but in between rounds they're just firing back to back, and I think it's super nice for us there because now the pools are like a little bit staggered and we can see multiple matches every single round, which is super interesting. And we see what decks do well in the different pools and what players do well.
Okay. So the person that we'll be featuring is Yoshiyuki once again. He's playing this very sweet control deck. And I think control is always one of the type of decks that we saw in the previous qualifier can dominate the tournament or like do really well in it once it's well established. Like the meta needs to well establish, so the control decks is the correct tools, which is very interesting, and I think it's also quite sane for the meta in this way. Otherwise we will have controls all over the course of a meta transition.
Control always adapts to what is being played, and it's really hard to play control going into something blind, but it's really impressive that Yoshiyuki has been able to perform really well with the control deck in a best of one format, and being 5-2 right now is a really, really good spot, and shows that he is a great player who pilot this deck in a certainly not well-known meta.
Exactly. I really like the inclusion, for example, of the Power Plant, a card that we haven't seen much right now, but especially since I think Picarom has made a comeback, and Power Plant hits Picarom really hard if they're not prepared for it. I think it's always a nice card that we have in the deck. It shuts down the Dennis, it shuts down Zero Aura, and can even cute packs that we might not expect.
Yeah, the The power plant is really just a prediction of like the Picarom decks opting out of Jirachi, I think. If you are able to shut down the Zera Aura, then that's really that the deck loses a lot of
Hello
mobility, right? They
everybody,
can't play Scuba
welcome
Map
back.
because they
Great,
only play
hope you had a
GX and
nice
D
break,
Pokemon,
everybody.
so
Welcome
they
back.
only
We are
have their
back
four
around
switches to
pages
work
still
with, and
And this is a beautiful start, actually, by Yoshiyuki. Look at that.
all the
Zacian,
basic
two
stuff.
basics, and a Noringuru. Beautiful. Absolutely wonderful.
Today by Martin
So yeah, he's looking pretty
Pfeiffer.
strong. We see the opponent starting with the Latias GX, a card that has been quite present in the past metas because of... There's always been sort of a GX that you need to be careful of. Hi, welcome back everybody, sorry for the quick interruption, we're just fixing some things. And yes, we're actually back into the game. Chinchino set up here from Yoshiyuki is looking pretty strong overall, and we actually see the opponent is playing Mewtwo Welder. We haven't seen much of this deck. How do you think it will fare up in this meta?
Mewtwo Welder is interesting because it's it doesn't really gain anything right now in terms of attackers. So like you already have your different attacking options, and I think Yoshiyuki will look to shut his opponent down as hard as possible by spamming power plant and recycling that. As you said, there's the power plant coming handy in that matchup as well. I don't think you aim to beat Welder Mewtwo with the inclusion of the power plant, but it's just nice to have versus them.
Exactly. It's also interesting because the Mewtwo and Mew has psychic weakness, and obviously Dragapult was the hype deck. So quite interesting choice by the opponent here to bring. Obviously Mewtwo and Mew is a very resourceful deck. It's always interesting to bring it into new metas because it usually has the tools to deal with it. So the opponent, I think, is Fear 5-2 as well. So he's doing pretty okay overall.
Yeah, we see Mewtwo just setting up, you know, getting all the attackers in the discard pile. Just what you like to see. But Yoshiyuki's setup is already better than the last time we saw his deck on stream. You know, he has already Chinchino on board and he was able to interpret sort multiple times. So I think he's pretty glad that the setup worked for him this time. And there we just see 60 damage.
Exactly. So we know the name of the opponent now. It's Alec Elhindi, and he's playing actually some interesting decks. He's playing, for example, the Incineroar GX from Team Up, the one that does damage, I think, for every damage that is placed on the opponent. Quite interesting.
And the regular attack from the Incineroar is like it does 130 for 3 colorless and discards a special energy, which shouldn't
Excellent.
Be too relevant, but
it's always interesting. And so we see actually a chip axe already from Yoshiyuki. He's already trying to control the opponent's draws. Obviously saw a bit of of a markdown from the opponent last turn. No knockout. This Oranguru is gonna stick around for at least a while. There's even a professor research, so Yoshiyuki is really going to accelerate in this position. Probably wants to evolve that Ditto into a Chinchino. We're just
going
fine
to
draw and draw
a lot of cards this time. This turn.
Even an Acrobike. Decides to get either the Skitty or the Oranguru. Let's remember that these players are playing for... Yoshiyuki is playing from Japan. For him, it's even... The game is even in English. So he needs to remember the... If he doesn't speak it well, he needs to remember all the cards by heart. So that's difficult. There we go. Chinchino evolved.
Second Chinchino coming down, drawing... Drawing more cards, just staking your hand, you know, just assembling all of the resources. And you even get the free turn right here to resource management if you like to, but I think Intrepid Sorting here is also fine.
Exactly. Let's remember, Yoshiyuki does play that one copy of Articuno GX. There it is. And Articuno is a card that has seen a lot of play, then kind of went down. But I think it's a really good card, in especially this kind of matchups in which energy are so important. Removing all the energies in one turn can mean, you know, doom for the opponent if it's not able to set up again.
It slows them, like, even if it doesn't remove them from the game completely, it might slow them down to a point where you're able to just get the lock on them, right? And deny them that many resources that they can't win anymore, even if you don't get the full lock. So, yeah, the combination of Gumi, Articuno is really, really strong, I think. Because Gumi is just so easy to access, you just throw it up into the active, and then if it gets knocked out, if your opponent commits the resources, your Lieutenant Search gets unlocked, and that's exactly what you want to see.
Yeah, I really like it as well, because it can deal with Dragapult quite well. Dragapult is obviously a deck that has no energy acceleration, if not for... We saw Bird, for example, in round one, playing that single copy of Malamar. But it's very clunky. You need to retreat it, you need to put it back into the active. So I really like the choice of playing Gumi here. Also, Yoshiyuki, coming from Japan, which is the country in which the precursors of the meta are usually there, I think it's really... He probably thought about this possibility. There we go, knockout finally on this Oranguru. This will enable Lieutenant Surge for Yoshiyuki. And the matchup between Mewtwo and Control has always been a 50-50 one. Do you think even today it's still like that?
Yeah, I think so, because as the Mewtwo player, I mean, I think it's even favored for Control. I think, because you're able to, like, at least at this game, say the Control player is favored, because you're in a good position where you can eventually get the headlock down and just put your opponent to one. And if they would go for, like, as we see, Yoshiyuki's opponent is playing Espeon Deoxys GX, so if they would set up for an Espeon Deoxys GX attack, it would just go for Articuno eventually.
Exactly. Wow! That's a lot of hammers!
That's a lot of crushing.
We're gonna be hammering, but that's tails. Let's see. That's a heads. Every heads is important in this matchup. Locking a Mewtwo in the active is super important. Wow.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. We haven't seen the power plant just yet from Yoshiyuki. Maybe it's in the prize cards.
There was one in the deck, I think.
Okay, there was one in the deck. I didn't catch that. Very nice. So that's exactly what you want to see.
There, that's the discards the Articuno. He does play two ordinary rods, so I think it's it. Another interesting inclusion, I think, is the, or rather, something that is lacking is the Pokédolls.
That's actually interesting that there are no Pokédolls.
Probably he just thought, well, Boss Orders is a card now. I think it's pointless. Just
might
invest
as well
your
not...
cards there.
Yeah, might as well not play it. But I think it's fine.
Oh, wow.
It's fine to not play the dolls, because you're able to execute your game plan a little bit quicker with the combination of Delcatty and Skitty and the scoop up net, because that way you can just search every turn, basically, and that makes you a lot faster overall, or like that makes your strategy a lot faster, because you also can play out of your discard pile.
Exactly, as you just said, Delcatty we see in action right now. That's the Delcatty, I think, Search for Friends is the ability, and once again, scoop up net, putting back the Skitty. He will be able to loop this at least for one turn more. Resource management eventually makes it infinite. So overall,
this combination of cards that, with the resource management right here, right, you're able to recover so many cards. Basically, this resource management recovers basically like 8 cards or something. Because you get the 2 scoop up net for the Delcatty eventually, and you get the 2 ordinary rod, which is the 1 ordinary rod, which is also like 4 cards. So, 1 resource management putting back 8 cards, basically 8 cards, which is insane.
Indeed, and there are always ways to exploit this attack that has been a scourge of the meta, really. We're happy to see it go. It is a card that has caused some controversy, because it beats itself in sort of way, but slowly over time it never did, because there were always more tools for the Control player to exploit resource management. But there we go, actually we see the lock is starting slowly to take form. This Mewtwo will be stuck there, not attacking because of the power plant in play. Once again, I really like this inclusion.
Yeah, there we see Sarge hitting the boss order, that's also important.
Massive, massive, massive.
And now it begins, right?
Yeah.
Now you're looking to reduce your opponent's hand to zero eventually. I think we will see another mass probably, would not be surprised.
Yeah. And there we go, search for friends once again. The little caddy fetching back a little bit of Bryce Cement and a Mars. Actually, Lieutenant Surge and a Mars. I think he's just going for, as you said, for the plan of reduce the opponent's hand to zero. Discarding a giant furnace, massive again.
Yeah, that's a dead or two really, really good hits right there. And yeah, if you go for that's so broken. If you go for double Grey Cat in one turn, you can basically like you can do whatever you want, right, with the four supporters that you would be able to get back in theory.
That's the ordinary road you were talking about, fetching back cards into his deck. Never gonna wheel himself out, even if the opponent had some cookie Macargo GX, which I don't think he plays. He would not be able to mill him out.
Yeah, there we see more recovery. I think you can just play out with the supporters out of your discard pile by trading away the cards that the ordinary rod recovers. I am really interested in seeing how Yoshiyuki will pull off the loop where you try to mill your opponent as fast as possible, because like this, of course, in theory you win the game, right, because your opponent doesn't do anything, but you need to finish it in 25 minutes as well.
Exactly.
So I'm really interested in seeing how Yoshiyuki will pull it off, but I think
now every turn, I mean, sure, at least this turn he'll be able to search for friends twice, so that's really big for him, because in this way he can just invest the resource management to the scoop up nets, and that's gonna mean that every turn he will have access to four cards, to four supporters, and that will probably be Chubalab and Bryceman every turn. Slowly and steadily, he will be able to grind out the opponent. At the same time, it adds up to the bench, to the discard of some Pokemons, but if there are no energies on board, that's not gonna do much.
Yes, if you're able to keep the energies off the board. I mean, if Mewtwo just get if the other deck, if you're playing control, if the other deck just misses one turn, you already feel great. But the Mewtwo player isn't sitting there and just passing.
Exactly. I'm not sure I liked this knockout that was took by the Mewtwo player right away. Because it activated the Lieutenant Surge, and usually you want to just take the first knockout if you're playing against control. Once you have a game plan, and once you're able to slow down your opponents already, for example with a Marnie or anything. That knockout right away just enabled Yoshiyuki Lieutenant Surge, and it's really hard to keep up.
Yeah, now it becomes pretty tough. There we see Reshiram and Breaks.
Breaks
and Charizard and Breaks, my bad.
Yeah,
down.
Exactly. Well, you made a connection with the
Not
Charizard.
Not every card has a Reshiram printed on it. Every card has Charizard printed on it. Don't forget that. And now the lock is in like complete action. I think Yoshiyuki will be able to reduce his opponent's hand down to zero this turn and start looping chip ice axes as well. And
exactly.
After that happens, then you can start to mill. Six.
Even a Faba removing the skateboard from the Dedenne, so no way to retreat for the opponent. You know, when you play this passively against mill, you're condemning yourself.
Yeah, we could also see just the Bell Elba here. I think that's fair. If your opponent doesn't do anything, no need to attack the hand. And there is another boss order hitting the discard pile. Scoop up
the second one.
Yeah, scoop up net, scoop up everything. And Yoshiyuki is essentially able to play out of this discard pile and do whatever he wants.
Chip packs for the Dedenne, he doesn't really mind. There's the power plant in play. As long as the opponent doesn't have another stadium in hand, we know he discarded already a giant Tarf. And I think he plays free, and Chu have already gone out.
I mean, if your opponent has just been sitting there, you probably know that he doesn't have the pieces required to do something, so you're just fine to go with that and reduce the hand.
And In all honesty, can even allow for a Dedenne because at this point he has already he's just a five prizes the opponent. He needs to like grind all the way into the game, and I think from here onward it's just downhill for Yoshiyuka.
Yeah,
Return resources are removed.
we see the mill for six this turn, and following it up with the chip chip ice axe. There's the Espeon and Deoxys, but that's way too late. And
Yeah.
also versus the Mincino version, it's not as effective, right? Because it can only like if you manage to pull off the GX attack for like six energy, which is
Exactly.
crazy enough, but yeah, you're only able to knock out two Pokemon, which is not that good.
Remember Torrid in the finals being able to pull off against Xander, was playing Mill and Torrid was playing Mewtwo. Thanks to that, Espeon Deoxys is so important. But right now, Pidgeotto is not played anymore. Mincino is sometimes just strictly better. And it has more HP, which I think is the most important thing of them all.
Yeah, I think it's better to play Cinccino in mill right now because you, or like in control, because you want to be able to protect yourself from manis by thinning out the cards that you don't need for your combos. And yeah, it just you are able to accumulate more cards in your hand, which is also one thing that's really important right now to
Interesting
get.
combo, as you said, like this Delcati. It shows once again how Scoop Up Net is a very threatening card, and I think a staple in many decks. It's just so important. Look at this. Every turn he's able to just do the combo, while, for example, in the previous version of Cinccino Mill, he just needed to take one turn to put back an escape rod or something else. But this turn, you are even every turn.
I
So.
think the most broken thing about Delcati and Scoop Up Net combo is with like essentially does the same thing as Pelpet, but it gets them this directly to your hand, and you don't have to draw into the Pelpet first and then draw into the supporters that you shuffled. So you
Exactly,
don't,
exactly.
all your overall cards card count in your hand stays the same, and you don't lose any cards. So yeah.
So that's the change, but it's not gonna happen. Just three cards left in deck and make do for. Well, he even has the Scoop Up Net in hand. We can just evolve and get the mill card. But yeah, so props to Yoshiyuka for winning this
Yeah,
game.
really clean,
Very, very,
and
very clean. Yes,
I
pretty
expect a
convincing.
lot of those decks to be on the PTCGO ladder really soon, so brace
Yeah.
yourself and tech for stall, I
Exactly.
guess.
Or Mr. Mime would have been fine, like the Mr. Mime that stops the scoop up block Mr.
The
Mime.
problem is that you have to get damage on the Delcatis then,
Yeah.
because Scooper Block only like blocks Pokemon with damage, but that
Exactly.
shouldn't be like it could be done, right?
Yeah,
So
it's doable with the Espeon Deoxys even for the small effect just to block down this broken combo. Obviously, you know, Stahl has always been a deck that is very hard to deal with. But
yeah.
overall, yes, very convincing game from Yoshiyuki. Props for this deck. It's probably his own invention. And yes, I think we will be right back with another match. I'm not too sure, but in any case, we'll be right back in case for the other round. See you soon.
See ya.